Okay, so on today's episode of Real Talk here at Basin Motorsports, let's talk about the conversation, or really what becomes an argument, over the built versus bought dilemma. So I will tell you, for a long time, I was one of those prideful guys that was very prejudiced against people that bought their way into everything. And really, it probably hasn't been until the last year that my opinion has changed. Growing up, I wanted to do everything myself. I wanted to build, I wanted to create, I wanted to fix everything. And honestly, I would go to car meets and I knew that it took me 3 months to buy a set of shocks, let's say. And I'd show up there knowing that I had to work a lot of extra shifts, or I had to save or something else, just to get that extra little bit of a part, like shocks. And I'd be there and I'd be, you know, man, look at my car, look at everything else. And then a guy would show up at $100,000 something or other that he paid somebody else to build. I will tell you, it flat infuriated me. How could somebody buy their way in and show up in something so nice when I knew what it took to get something ratty just to get to the car meet? So about a year ago is when it really changed for me. And that was when I went from the guy that was trying to do everything to someone that was trying to start a business. And I realized building cars is really kind of like art to me. This is how I think about it. I can't say that someone is not an art aficionado if they buy like a very good painting, right? They go out and buy a Van Gogh, they would go and buy, you know, buy something in an auction like that. You can't really say they're not an art aficionado. Just don't call them an artist, right? They didn't paint it, they bought it. But if you went to their house and saw it on the wall, you'd be like, hey, you're in a high level aficionado. You've got really good stuff that you bought. And I started thinking about that in terms of cars. People that buy stuff, they don't show up to these car meets typically and say, hey, look at this 69 Camaro or this Ford Mustang or anything else. You can ask them, where'd you get it? And if they bought it and tell you they built it themselves, okay, that is a problem and I will agree, shame on them. But if they can't change a set of spark plugs in a lawnmower and they have the wherewithal, if they're an executive and they don't have time or the resources to go build a car, but they love cars and they want to buy one, who am I to say that they're wrong? How am I to say they're not an enthusiast? They're just not a mechanic. So I think, honestly, the dilemma, the argument, whatever you want to call it, of this built versus bought thing, it's complete bull. Just admit that you bought the car. And where's the problem? We're all car enthusiasts. Just own up to what you can do. Sometimes we have to pay other people to build for us. That's just the way it is. And as a guy trying to build a garage that builds for other people, I'm not going to shame you for wanting to come to me to pay me money to build for you. I'm going to thank you. So with that today, don't let the built versus bought thing turn from pride of building to prejudice against those that can't, but can afford to buy parts for someone else to build for them. That's it for this time. Don't be prejudiced. Be thankful that people want to pour money into our enthusiast market. It's good for us. That's it. See you next time from Basin Motorsports.